About Dogs on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Kennel Club and by the Berks County Dog Training Club.
Good evening and welcome to the Berks County Kennel Club's program, All About Dogs. Hi, I'm Pat Mock, your host. And before we meet our guests, I would first of all like to present BCTV with these checks. One is from the Berks County Dog Training Club in the amount of $200. The other is from the Berks County Kennel Club, and it's in the amount of $1,000. We support BCTV, and we hope you do too. Now, on to our guests. And of course, obviously, you saw at the start of the program, the babies. So we're going to talk, first of all, to Diane Myers and her Chows, and she brought her friend Scott and also her friend Tara with her to help her explain about it. Well, actually, they came as holders, but anyhow, what she brought were her Chows, and they come in two different coats, which I'm not quite sure most of you know about. They come in the rough and the smooth. Is it called a smooth, Diane?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. So suppose you tell us actually what a Chow, first of all, it's such a funny name. What does Chow mean? They used to be called Chow Chow.
They still are called Chow Chow.
They still are called Chow Chows. Okay. All right. Because, you know, I only ever see Chow Chow Chows. So what is it?
Right.
You don't know either.
I don't know. It was just the name that was given to the breed.
But doesn't it, wasn't it way back when they first, when the Chinese were first doing them, that Chow Chow meant just a conglomeration of things? Isn't that what, like when you get Chow Chow in a mix, you know, in the,
yes,
the jar, it's Chow Chow,
right,
and it's all mixed up vegetables?
They used to eat
pickled dogs.
They ate Chow Chow as well.
Okay.
I don't know if you wanted to know that.
No, that's a little too much information. We'll go on from there.
Okay.
So what actually were they bred for?
Chows were bred for herding and hunting,
oh,
pulling, and guarding temples.
Oh, wow. So they were really all-around dogs.
Yes.
Jeez, that's amazing. I didn't know. I didn't know they were herding dogs.
Yes.
It's just they don't look like they could do the job.
Yes,
they just
and
don't.
They're very strong, and they're very powerful for pulling.
Really?
Yes.
Wow. That's just amazing. So they are, even the smooth is very hairy.
Yes.
Right.
They're still a double-coated breed.
Okay. Okay.
But they just don't get
the longer hair.
The lion look rough. They don't have all the hair on the tail.
Uh-huh.
And the long hair on the breeches and the long hair that comes off of the front legs.
Okay. Yeah, we can see that. I was going to say we can't really see her front legs, but you actually can. How many colors do they come in? Because you usually see them in this color or else black. They either,
yes,
come in the red or the black.
Yes, there's several shades of reds.
Okay.
They're both reds.
Okay.
And they also have the black,
uh-huh,
the blue, cream, and cinnamon.
Oh, okay. So what color is cinnamon?
Cinnamon is almost like a dusty beige.
Oh,
and sometimes,
okay,
can have a pink cast to it when the sun hits it.
Oh, okay.
And the blue, okay, is like a slate gray color.
Yeah. Yeah, like most of the other, they call them blue and they all look gray to me.
Right, and the creams are like off-white.
Yeah.
Some are as almost pure white, but they,
wow,
always have biscuit highlights,
yeah,
like on their ears.
Now, can they come in white or isn't that?
Yes, they do.
They can come in
they
white?
They do,
white?
But the,
okay,
pigment usually isn't as good on them,
oh,
as far as their noses.
Okay.
They lose their pigment on their nose.
Okay.
Noses.
Okay.
And so they can't be shown.
Okay, okay. So their noses have to be black, but also, well, they have the black eye trim too, don't,
yes,
they?
Yes, they,
okay,
have to have the black eye rims.
Okay. And the tongue has to be black?
Yes.
Okay. Why is the tongue black?
It is a mystery.
Nobody
no one knows why that they have the pure black tongue. It is a disqualification if they don't have the black tongue.
Wow.
And the only other breed that has the black tongue is the Chinese Sharpei.
Isn't that interesting? Now, if you bred that to something else, like if you bred it to, say, a Labrador Retriever, would you get the black tongue? Or would you
possibly
only get the black tongue in some and not in others? Or
you may get spotted. It,
okay,
would be called,
okay,
a flowered tongue.
Okay.
But the black gene for the tongue is a dominant,
oh,
gene. So
wow. That's really, you know, it, it's like Dalmatians with the spots. Nobody knows where it came from. You know, it's like, okay, it has spots, but yes, it is a mystery.
Yes.
Genetics are just wonderful, aren't they? Yeah, yeah.
I think they're too hot together.
Yeah, probably. So how popular is this breed?
It was very popular, got actually too popular in the 80s.
Was it in the 80s?
Yes.
Okay.
It was up in the top 10.
Oh, wow.
And now it's fallen drastically.
Huh.
Which is okay.
Yeah, that's exactly
right.
You don't really want the most popular breed because then everybody and their brother wants to breed them.
Right, and everybody would buy a chow from a pet shop or a backyard breeder and they were breeding it. And
yeah.
Chows can be known not to have the best temperament and it has a lot to do with breeding and genetics.
Okay. Yeah, that was the next thing I was going to ask you, because these guys seem very friendly. I mean, they were very enthusiastic coming in to greet me, and yet you hear that, you know, oh, don't get near them, don't get near them. Mm-hmm. And I've known a couple that you couldn't get near, but...
And I have two over the years. I got my first chow in 1981.
Okay, okay.
And I got it from, out of the newspaper, somebody had bred their female, and I learned a lot. She wasn't show quality. But I did obedience with her. Mm-hmm. She was high scoring and sub novice.
Wow.
But the thing about the chows is once they know they're off leads, they like to take off.
Yes. No. A lot of other breeds will do the same thing. So are
she did really well.
Yeah. Are they easy to train? Or are they sort of, because of the curly tail, they have their own agenda? Scott shaking his head.
Yeah. Chows are very cat-like.
Okay.
So they can be very aloof, and they sometimes will, you can be calling them, and they don't hear you, or they pretend they don't hear you. But then again, there's some that just want to please you and learn very, very quickly.
Okay, okay.
They do agility and rally and obedience with chows.
Huh.
They are very intelligent, but... It has to be their idea.
Yes, their own idea. That's exactly right. Because so many of the curly-tailed dogs, just, you know, they do their own thing. And it's like, if you want to do this with me, fine. But if you don't want to do it with me, well, you know, the heck with you.
Right.
But
right.
They, I mean, as far as house training, they're easy to housebreak. They're clean dogs.
Oh, I have a little brag. These babies have not gone potty in the house since they were 5.5 weeks old.
Oh, wow. How old are the babies?
They're almost 7 weeks.
Wow. Almost 7 weeks. Now, look how big these puppies are at 7 weeks.
Look
at
their paws.
Yes, look at their paws. Now, this is also...
This is a smooth coat.
Okay.
Yes, this is a smooth coat puppy, and this is a rough coat puppy.
Now, they don't look very much different. To me, they don't look very much different.
With all his coat?
Yeah, this one looks almost as hairy as that one.
Well, he actually...
He is a little bit hairy.
He has a lot more hair, and it's very thick and very dense.
Are they both boys?
They're both boys.
Okay, okay.
One fact about a chow is that when they're born, their tongues are pink. They're born with pink tongues.
And they get dark later?
Yes. So generally, by the time they're... 8 weeks old, they should be completely turned. Oh. I believe this puppy's is already.
Is it?
And this one has a little bit on the pink yet.
Oh, how about that?
I know.
Now, that one, not this one, but that one has a black face.
Yes.
Is that preferred, or doesn't it matter? Is it going to, you know, as he gets older and his hair grows out, is he going to lose that black?
It'll fade.
Will
black,
it? Okay.
That's called a black mask.
Okay.
And it just depends on their color, the gene makeup of them. Not all puppies will have the black mask.
Okay.
But they will eventually lose it.
Huh.
But it makes it pretty darn cute, isn't
it? Oh, yes, it is. Having a black-faced breed myself, yes, I think that's very attractive. Now, their eyes are so tiny. Is that because they have the wrinkled skin like the pay? I mean, you can't really tell that with, you know, all this hair. You can't really tell anything.
They do get some wrinkles, but not a lot of wrinkles.
Okay.
But their head, the way their head is made up, their eyes are very deep set.
Uh-huh.
And that's just a characteristic of the breed. So their peripheral vision isn't the best. It's always better to approach a chow from the front.
Okay.
And you always want to approach them and scratch them under their chin first.
Uh-huh.
They don't really like a hand going over them.
Well, most breeds don't.
But if you train them that way, if you train them that way, then they're fine with it.
Yes, it's just that the eyes look so small. I guess I'm not used to seeing so small an eye. And the other one is, the furry one is even more so than this one.
And I think with all his coat, sometimes it makes it harder to even see their eyes.
Now when do their ears stand up? Because they still have the dropped ears.
Yeah. His are starting to come up.
Yeah, this one is starting.
They're starting to come up. And I thought his were just one of his is up so far.
Okay.
But generally, I don't even worry about it till they're about 3 months old.
Okay, okay.
And then there's things to help.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Just putting some little new skin under there just for support.
Yeah, because they don't have real big ears.
No, they're not. They have very, Sam's got gorgeous ears. He has very small ears. And the Chows have the almond-shaped eyes.
Mm-hmm.
And they're supposed to have this scowl that makes them look aloof.
Or always annoyed about something.
Yeah. No, Sam looks like he's smiling all the time. Don't you, Samuel?
So now, as far as grooming, with Sam, how long does it take you to groom them?
Well, even though there are two different type coats, the smooth and the rough, they still both have a double coat.
Uh-huh.
So it takes a while to wet them down. It takes a while to get down to the skin.
Yes. Uh-huh.
So I would say on an average from start to finish, start bathing them, blowing them out.
Mm-hmm.
And we have pretty good hair dryers. Like, it'd probably take a lot longer.
Yeah, but I mean, for like a general person, if I wanted a Chow, and I wanted to know, well, how often must I brush this dog? Once a day, once a week, once a month? You know, how often do I need to brush that kind of coat?
Well, their coats are harsh. The outer coat is a harsh coat.
Okay.
So you could get away with brushing a Chow every 2 weeks.
Wow.
Yeah,
okay.
they don't mat.
Okay.
They don't mat up. But from start to finish, as far as bathing and blowing a dog out, it's probably an average of 3 hours.
Okay. Yeah, like most long-coated dogs.
Right.
Yeah. But you don't have to worry about the snow, because I'm sure they probably love that.
They love the snow.
Right. Now, they were actually guard dogs at the temples?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes,
okay.
They would guard temples.
Okay. But now we've adapted them so that they're sweet pets.
They're wonderful pets. They're very easy to train, to housebreak. They don't need a lot of exercise. They're very good apartment dogs.
Are they really?
Very good apartment dogs. Very quiet.
How are they with kids?
Wonderful with kids.
Oh, okay.
If they're raised with kids. Even these two older ones, we don't have children, so they weren't raised with children.
Right.
They love children.
Wow. Okay. Well, I guess that goes back to the farming heritage.
And
you know, you can't harm the stock. I mean, you know, you kill the sheep and, you know, that's one of the dogs in the Chow Chow mix, right?
Right. And I teach them from very young to take their food from them, pet them while they're eating, because I've heard so many stories of babies being bitten when a dog is eating.
Yeah,
and so
go ahead.
I was just going to say, I try to do everything to make their adjustment to a new home easy.
Your transition.
Yeah. Yes.
As far as health problems, what health problems are we looking at here?
Probably one of the I won't say one of the biggest issues, but some of the health issues that Chows can have would be entropion, which is turning in of the eyelids.
Yeah.
And it's because when they're young, a Chow isn't fully grown until they're 3-4 years old.
Okay.
So the heads keep coming on, and then sometimes they'll start to close in their heads and they'll get the rolling in.
Okay.
But you don't even need a heavy head to have entropion.
Mm-hmm. Right.
It just has to do with genetics.
Yeah.
And it's actually
a very painful condition
because
the eyelashes are constantly rubbing on the eyeball itself.
Right. It's like having sand in your eye.
Yeah. So they actually do need surgery.
Yes, they should.
Right.
Absolutely. Another issue, which is most breeds, would be hip dysplasia.
Really?
Yes.
Okay. Huh.
So it's very important to health test.
Okay.
You know.
Any other homework specific to this breed?
I don't know if it's just specific to this breed, but we've been doing a lot of research on stomach cancer.
Oh, okay. Okay. So that seems to be in a fair number of breeds.
A lot of breeds.
Yes. In fact, I guess, the place we all donate to.
OFA?
No. The
Foundation.
Pardon?
Canine Health Foundation?
Yes, 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 oh. yes. Canine Health Happy. Foundation and the lab that they work with. Oh, well, it doesn't really matter. But yeah. I think they're doing a lot of testing.
They are a lot of research.
Yeah. Yeah.
We
yeah.
just had shows recently where there was a foundation there doing DNA testing mm-hmm. on chows to find the gene for smooth and rough coats.
Oh.
And also to find the marker for their straight rear assembly.
Yes. That was another thing I wanted. If actually, you can see it really good on her.
On Sam.
Yeah, on him.
Yep.
Oh, I got the wrong ones. Okay.
Oh, that's all right. Sam.
You can see how the back end, they don't have actually a knee that comes out. It sort of goes straight down. Well, you can't really see now that.
There.
There. Now you can see how straight that back leg is.
Right.
In the front, not in the back, but in the front.
No, in the back, they do not have the rear end angulation.
Yeah, yeah.
So when you watch them move from the side when they're gating, they actually swing from the hip. It's like a pendulum.
Okay.
They don't have that drive
yes,
in the rear
yes, yes.
that a lot of dogs have.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, very good. Very good. A lot of hair.
Yeah.
A lot of hair. So now we're going to go to Jim, and Jim is going to tell us about his Xoloiyzcuintli.
Squeakly.
Squeakly. Okay. You say
okay.
it.
Xoloiyzcuintli.
Okay. And the Xoloiyzcuintli is a what? A hairless dog. Can you get a close-up of, what's her name?
Perla.
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 Okay. Perla.
The Perla Negra for the Black Pearl.
Oh, the Black Pearl. Okay.
Oh,
well,
nice.
You can't see her against dark shirt now. But you can see she doesn't have any. Hi, sweetheart. She doesn't have any hair. She's all skin except for a couple of little things on the top of her head. You can see she's got a few little hairs on the top of her. It's like she went bald. Now, what was this breed bred for?
Well,
I don't want her.
They were thought to have been a self-made breed in Mexico and Central America, but they were. Like the chows, they were also eaten by the ancient Aztecs. But as the breed grew in popularity down there, and they become more popular, they thought they were a dog of the gods because they thought they were able to cure arthritis because they don't have hair, they feel warmer to
yes,
touch
yes.
than a coated dog.
Uh-huh.
So they liked sleeping with these dogs. They liked them. Put them on if you had arthritis, they thought they were able to cure illnesses.
How about that?
So they've become the national dog of Mexico now.
Wow, okay. Now, they do come with hair?
Oh yeah, they come in two varieties, the coated and the hairless.
Okay.
And three sizes.
Oh, okay.
The toy, miniature, and standard.
Well, what is she?
She's a standard.
Okay, so what is the toy?
The toy's have to be at least, they're supposed to be at least 10 inches tall.
Oh,
10
okay.
to 14.
Okay, that's about so big.
Then the miniatures are over 14 up to 18. The standards are over 18 up to 23.
Wow, and what is she? She's only about 21, isn't
She's
she?
She's about 22 and a half, actually.
Really? She's mm-hmm. that tall? Wow, mm-hmm. I didn't think she was that tall. But now, if you have a hairless one, they only have this teeny little bit of hair. Is it only on the head, or do they have little hairs on the body, or?
The hairless ones are allowed to have hair on the top of their skull,
okay,
on their feet, and on the last third of their tail.
Oh.
Now you'll see some with more,
uh-huh.
And a lot of people, who, if they're showing, they'll do a little sculpting or they'll do a little shaving. But she's a true hairless. She really, I mean, she has a light dusting of hair on the top
yeah,
of her skull.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
And that's it.
Yeah, and she doesn't have any hair on the tail at all.
Sometimes they'll get little tufts of hair on their body,
okay.
which we just pluck, or a lot of times they'll come right out with a loofah when you bathe in them.
Now, you would think a hairless dog, and you said just said a loofah, so you would think hairless dog, well, you don't need to do anything.
Oh, no, they take some care. They need regular bathing.
I would think so, because it's just like, do they get
skin?
Right. Do they get pimples, like, you know, if you don't?
They can get some.
Okay.
They're not. It's not as rampant in this breed as some of the other hairless breeds. Sorry, she's got manners.
She doesn't need manners.
They bathe once a week and then put lotion on them to keep them from drying out because they're a very dry-skinned dog.
Okay.
And if you let them get too dry, that's when they get the pimples and from
the... probably cracked skin, you know, just like we do.
Yeah.
But how is she, like, in the cold weather? How does she... Mexico is hot. You know, here she is up north where we get snow.
But they don't appreciate the cold very well, but they do. My dogs are dogs, and they do go out in the snow, and she will play in the snow.
Really?
Not very long, but she'll play in the snow.
Oh, my word. You would think she'd get frozen.
And we have a little one. She is only about 10 inches tall. She's 13 years old. She was our first, and she absolutely hates wearing clothes, so... She goes out, does her business, and right back in.
Now, are these guys easy to train?
They're very smart. They're very clean. But they can be pretty active.
Okay.
I don't know that I would recommend them for the first-time dog owners because they're problem solvers.
Uh-oh.
And they will get into trouble if left to their own devices.
Uh-huh. Oh yes, that's the problem. Most people don't think about that. It's like, well, you know, it's a dog, and when they learn how to problem solve, it's not nice.
Yeah.
You have to think ahead of the dog,
right.
and most people don't do that.
Right.
And then it's the dog's fault.
And then they end up in a shelter or something because
that's
they don't know how to train them.
Are these dogs very popular?
They're still a fairly rare breed.
Okay. They were just not that long ago recognized by the AKC, right?
Yeah, well, for the second time. They were one of the original breeds that the American Kennel Club registered when the AKC was formed.
Oh, my word.
But they were dropped out of the registry in, I think it was 1952, because of the lack of interest in this country and not enough dogs for them to maintain stud books.
Yeah.
So now they've kind of made a resurgence and...
Isn't that interesting? Well, now people, I guess, want the odd and unusual.
Unusual.
And yeah. They definitely are.
They fit that bill.
That's exactly right. They fit that bill. I just like hair.
See, I...
But this would
I
be...
I don't. So.
Yeah.
So, and I've gone from this length to this. I love the no hair.
But, you know, it's just so unusual looking. Now, what about health problems with these guys, since they're such an old breed?
I'm fairly new to the breed, even though our first one is 13 years old. She was a rescue.
Okay.
And she's had no health problems whatsoever yet.
Wow.
And I haven't found anything with...
Yeah. Well, I would think, too, being such an old breed of dogs, that if there was a lot of... health problems, they would have just not been bred. They would have died out.
Well, yeah, and that's probably why there were not enough breeders to screw up the gene pool.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
It may be a different story in the coming generations, but...
Because it's like the Afghans who, you know, don't have any problems at all, you know, but...
They're still a fairly primitive breed.
Yeah. But they come in other colors as well?
Oh, yeah. Even the hairless ones come in other colors. They come in a slate gray. They come in a bronze. They come in black. They come in red.
Huh.
They're allowed to have white markings.
Okay.
Actually, she had puppies in May, and some of her puppies had white spots. But they've gone. Now they're 5 months old, and the white spots have gone away. I never knew that white spots in the skin would go away, but they do.
Now, what does the one with hair look like?
It's a single coat. It's fairly dense. It's really...
What other breed of dog might it look like?
I've never been able to find another breed has that type of hair coat. And they come in any color. They can be black and tan, brindle, merle, cream, red, white.
So now, do you have to breed this to another hairless one? Or is it like the Chinese crested that you have to breed a hairless one to a coated one so that you don't have any genetic problems?
You can get, doesn't matter what you breed, you're going to get hairless and coated in the same breed unless you breed coated to coated.
Uh-huh.
Then you're only going to get coated.
Oh, okay. Wow, that's interesting. They don't have any dental problems then?
Because the gene that makes them hairless also makes them have missing teeth.
Yes.
So they are missing some of their premolars.
The premolars, okay.
They have their incisors. A lot of times they don't get their adult canines in, where the coated varieties, they must have full dentition.
Okay.
And they usually do have all of their teeth.
Are they then shown as just one breed?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, they're shown all together.
Okay. Well, man, we ran out of time already. That's not good. Well, that's our program for this evening, so I guess we'll say good night.
About Dogs on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Kennel Club and by the Berks County Dog Training Club.